if they recognize that their future is bound up together, what is necessary is to believe that in this life all is not whatever you see. And the only way that even is to go on and live your life. That's what Mandela, that was Mandela's genius was. And he had the moral authority to do it because he spent 27 years in prison. He was physically and emotionally abused. He was separated from his family. He never got to see his soul in the world. So he could get out and say, look, whatever you pay, my dues are higher. We are not going to punish everybody. We're going to set up this Truth and Reconciliation Commission. If people will come forward and admit what they've done, we'll find a way for them to do something about it without putting half the country in jail. Because we have to go forward together. I mean, basically, if you look at what he did as compared with what Mugabe did in Rhodesia and Zimbabwe, you see how bad it was. Or look at Rwanda, where the minority Tutsis and their Hutu allies suffered breathtaking casualties. Here's a country of 8 million people killed 10% of the country in 90 days. And the president essentially gave amnesty to all the two soldiers who fled the Congo and come home and live in the communities and just submit themselves to community justice. And they couldn't be put in jail, they couldn't be beaten, they couldn't be harassed. They just were supposed to do something to atone for what they had done before in the community. I think these are the kind of things you have to do. But I've seen stunning, you know, I wrote about this in the book. I met a woman in Rwanda whose husband and 6 children were murdered, and the people who murdered her tried to kill her. So she wakes up in her own blood to see her husband and 6 children lying dead around her. You know, if anything happened to my daughter, I would have had a long life. She decided that she would adopt children on both sides of the country. Get permanent places. She said God had spared her for a reason.